In late 1965, my husband Len and I went to Israel for the very first time with a group called Shirut La'am, which means service to the people. It was a program that was sponsored by the Jewish Agency, and as part of that, we lived on a kibbutz near the Sea of Galilee. It's called Degania, Degania Bet. And while we were on Degania, we were taken on various tours through the country. The country was pretty new in 1965. So one of our trips took us to Jerusalem, and we were on the balcony of the King David Hotel. And while we were there, we were able to look over a no man's land, which today is a beautiful park. It's the Mamilla Shopping Mall, filled with coffee shops and shops, and is just a tourist haven. But at that time, we were able to look over into what was Jordan in the old city, and on the parapets of the old city, and on the tower, King David's Tower, we saw Jordanian soldiers with their guns at ready, waiting for somebody to try to cross into the old city from the Israeli side. So as young Americans, we were only in our early 20s at the time, as young Americans, this was a real shock to us because we, of course, had never experienced anything quite as military as that, even though at that time in the United States, many of our friends were going to Vietnam, but never had been so close to that kind of a situation. So we lived in the Jordan Valley, and at the time my husband would go off in the morning to work in the banana fields and such places, and right above these banana plantations was Jordan and Syria on the Golan Heights. And so he also had the experience of being close to danger. He passed many signs that said, border ahead, do not continue, border ahead, do not continue. So this was all of an eye-opening experience for us to see how Israel was totally marginalized by its neighbors. So when we came back from Israel, I became an elementary school teacher. And just a few months later, my first year of teaching, was when the war took place. It was in June, the end of that first year of teaching. And so I was in Oakland, and I remember telling my students at the time, while the war was going on, that the Oakland Hills were just like the hills of the Golan looking over the Jordan Valley. And they also, like we hadn't had any experience or any understanding of that, they also had absolutely no understanding of what was going on 10,000 miles away. So when the Six-Day War ended, and our soldiers went into the old city, and we saw the soldiers praying at the wall, and the tears that were flowing, and just the joy that was experienced by people who lived in Jerusalem and couldn't go into the old part of the city and so on, we felt such pride in Israel and our adopted country. And we will never forget that. That experience has changed our lives through all the years since then. There's always the hope that it will happen. I guess I'm not surprised because there's such animosity, and it's such a shame. And I work very hard on different organizations that I'm active in to reach out to other communities, to teach them about Israel, to teach them about the goodness of the people there, and about the dreams that the people have to be accepted, not only in the area, but in the world as a sovereign nation. If I were really and truly an optimist, and I hope I am, I would love to see peace happen. I see a lot of things that Israel has developed, a lot of the technology that Israel has developed and is willing to share with its neighbors, the water technology and so on, the agricultural technology and the drip irrigation, for example. Would be a boon to these countries, and Israel would be very willing to share it with them. It would be very nice if it were to come to pass. I hope it does.